Mount Kilimanjaro is one of the largest mountains in the world, an extraordinary location. But what a lot of people don't know about it is it's home to some of the best ice climbing in the world, or at least it has been until now. In 2014, I climbed the ice fins on top of Kilimanjaro. There's these just shark fins sticking out of the landscape up there. And even then, scientists were saying that by 2020, they could be gone. The roof of Africa used to be covered in ice, really covered. And now there's these lonely little ice cubes out there in the middle of the desert.
We have a really strong team along with us. We have Christian Pondella, who took some of the really iconic pictures in 2014.
Using Christian's photos from 6 years ago as our record, how different will it all look now?
I'm really excited and nervous to see what's still there. So, mainly I just want to get going. It's been a lot of traveling to get here, and now it's time to go.
Check it out.
Is that it?
That's the old fin.
That's it?
Wow.
That's not the same fin.
That used to be a fin.
You got those photos?
It is pretty much unrecognizable, isn't it?
That's different.
Yeah, this is the fin.
That's where that canyon was that we went through. This used to be kind of a gateway right here. And now it's, now you could fly a plane through there, you know? It's massive. The fin I climbed on is gone. And the piece that used to be the size of a couple of houses is down to, you know, a good sized bar could go through that in a night for drinks. So, yeah, massive changes up here in the last few years.
Doug has spent his life researching what glaciers can teach us about climate. This is his 21st expedition to the top of Kilimanjaro, and he understands more than anyone about this unique ice here on the equator.
So, big question here is, why is the ice on Kilimanjaro disappearing?
It really seems that the ice is suffering here for changes in humidity in the atmosphere. So for lack of clouds and more clear sky, so that there's more energy received at the surface, which is causing the lowering of the glacier.
I hear climate change and I think global warming. This is all about global warming.
Yeah.
But this isn't really about the temperature rising. It's about the climate changing and there being less snow here, making less ice, and then it being drier, so the ice here evaporates quicker.
Exactly right. Your key word there is change. The carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is really changing everything.
Over one century, from 1912, scientists estimate that 90% of the ice on Kili disappeared.
You really can see dramatically how the ice extent has changed over time.
Yeah.
But the rate of loss seems to be getting even faster. Measuring the glacier next to this fin, Doug calculates it's reduced by a further 70% since we were here just 6 years ago. With Doug's help, I'm beginning to understand that the ice up here is acting as an important marker of how our planet is responding to climate change.
It's shocking. There's no other word for it. It is genuinely shocking.
I didn't expect it to go this fast. Like, it's just disappearing so quickly now.
Meters thick. Yeah, I find that really frustrating. A lot of what I've done with my life is climb ice, so I show up and it's not there. And it's not just Kilimanjaro, it's globally. It's a problem for ice climbers, but it's a much bigger problem for the rest of the world. I think it's a little bit of an awakening for me. I do need to do more.
What I've seen here will change how I live my life. I will use less carbon going forward, full stop.